Actually, it is the areas in the smaller provinces of today and the backward areas that stand immediately and positively to gain from the merger. Smaller provinces, which have to look to the center for subventions and doles, will, on merger, share as of right in the revenues and resources of the whole of West Pakistan. The backward areas will be in a position to claim and will be entitled to receive equal attention in the same manner as the less advanced districts in the same province receive attention from the provincial ministry in the province. The people in the existing smaller units will have available to them the social and other services of government on the same pattern as in the more advanced provinces. Resources surplus to the advanced areas will be allowed to flow naturally into the development of poorer areas without the hindrance of any artificial boundaries or political barriers. My colleagues and I are convinced that for the hitherto backward and neglected areas, the unification of West Pakistan holds out a brighter future. Fears of domination by any one existing province over others are born of the present atmosphere of provincial jealousies, suspicion, and mistrust. With the disappearance of provincial boundaries, new political, social, and economic forces will come into play and will sweep away the artificial divisions which obstruct the natural unity of the people. Now, for centuries, the virus of provincialism has been corroding our body politic. The malady has become chronic. Therefore, we cannot effect a miraculous overnight cure. Habits of thought take time to change, and it is only over a period of years that proper psychological adjustment can be made. For this reason, it is proposed that in the West Pakistan legislature, for a limited number of years, representation will have to be arranged so as to eliminate the possibility of domination by any one area over the others. Also, there need be no fear that as a result of the unification of the Western zone, the development of existing provincial languages will suffer, or that any special existing facility or safeguards as regards representation in the services will disappear. You may all rest assured that necessary administrative arrangements will be made in order to fully protect the legitimate rights and interests of people of every area of West Pakistan. Special facilities for recruitment in government services will be granted to backward areas, and the rights and conditions in the various existing provinces will also be adequately safeguarded. You might be interested to learn that a small body of administrative experts is already engaged in the task of fashioning the pattern of administrative machinery that will be necessary when West Pakistan is unified and constituted into a single province. This committee will also advise government on the manner in which the special interests of each area can be fully protected under the proposed new arrangement. I now propose to give a brief rundown of the advantages of the abolition of the existing provincial barriers. More than anything else, the single move will ultimately destroy provincialism. Within a short time, people will cease to think of themselves as Punjabis, Sindhis, Baluchis, or Pathans. Instead, they will begin to think of themselves as Pakistanis. The proposal envisages two provincial governments, namely the government of East Pakistan and the government of West Pakistan. This will mean designating the province of East Bengal as East Pakistan. The federal government will be the government of Pakistan. In one single step, we can do away with the names of different provinces such as East Bengal, West Punjab, Sindh, Northwest Frontier Province, Baluchistan, Bhawalpur, Khairpur, etc. With their disappearance, there will be no Bengali, no Punjabi, no Sindhi, no Pathan, no Baluch, no Bhawalpuri, and no Khairpuri. Now, I am sure you will agree that this will help promote national unity and reinforce the idea of single nationhood. It will strengthen the integrity of Pakistan. Then again, the end result of the unification of West Pakistan will be that this will be a significant improvement in the political atmosphere. The development of backward areas will be accelerated. Such areas will receive equal, if not greater, attention than other areas. Capital, administrative, and private talent will flow naturally as between one area and another. The forces of economic progress will operate more freely throughout Pakistan, drawing the best in all its provinces, animating and developing all of them in the interests of the country as a whole. The merger of the provinces in the western zone will, in addition, enable us to conserve our administrative and economic resources and to devote them more effectively to the rapid development of the single large province. The existing wasteful duplication in administrative setups in the various smaller units will be avoided. The provincial administration will be considerably cheaper but vastly more efficient. In place of the existing multiplicity of separate administrations, there will be a single streamlined administration operating throughout West Pakistan. Once West Pakistan is constituted into a single political unit, the task of framing a new constitution for the country will have become simple. It will then resolve itself primarily to evolving a constitutional pattern in which both West Pakistan and East Pakistan are placed on a footing of equality, promoting a feeling of partnership. These two units will then go forward in an honorable, mutual, beneficial, complementary, and enduring partnership, thus advancing the prosperity of the country as one whole. I am more than convinced that by working on these lines, we can promote the stability of our country and build ourselves into a strong, powerful, and united nation. My colleagues and I have dedicated ourselves to this great task for strengthening the integrity of Pakistan and accelerating its progress. I am convinced that in this endeavor, we shall have the blessings and support of every man and woman of goodwill in the country. Khuda Hafiz. Pakistan Zindabad.